Alright, what's going on people? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Aiden and today we are watching It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia Season 4 Episode 3. See, I told you we're going to get through it a little bit faster now. 3 episodes in 2 days. Pretty good for my current speed, or my recent past speed. So I've actually found recording early has helped me become a lot more productive with the actual videoing. I don't have to worry about it taking up other time. Like right now, it is 8 a.m. So, you know, before I've got to start working on bits and bobs, you know. As you can see, I've got some lighting. I still haven't figured out how to actually use it properly. But I do like the idea of trying to figure out what to do with this setup. I mean, I do have a black screen, a black fabric that I did have hanging up on the wall, but the issue is this, obviously I'm using a GoPro as my webcam, and even on its narrow setting, it's still way too wide. So, now you can even get the door. There's no, I can't go the whole route of the actual, this wall, you know. It's a bit annoying. But yeah, I like the rim lighting around my base on that side. I think that's quite cool. In the last episode, the gang solved the gas crisis by what? Trying to get a loan of $300,000 and just buying all of the gasoline. They're just going to store it in their basement and hope it goes up in a year or two. I mean, it might have worked, to be honest. Just the issue is, you know, do you trust leaving that somewhere dark and dodgy like a basement? I don't think I would. So instead they tried to sell it door to door, and they became oil barons. Yeah, Mac became some kind of Saudi Arabian prince with his head thingy-majig. Yeah, Charlie became some kind of southern character with his cowboy hat, his leather jacket, and his awkwardly bad accent. And his poor choicing of words, which makes people uncomfortable. But yes, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you leave a like rating and comment down below what you thought about this episode. Subscribe so you can stay up to date when I upload next. And I think I should have a reaction out to The Naked Gun, which is my first movie reaction in a long time. So check that out, let me know what you think about that as well. And also comment on that, what other movie you think would be worth me watching that I'd enjoy and also would be decent for the channel, you know. If you're interested in getting these episodes early and access to the full length reactions to these, then you can find that in the Patreon, which is the link in the description. But yes, let's get into this.
Mac here with another installment of Project Badass.
Oh Jesus.
As you can see, the ramp
extreme.
Is about 40 feet down there. I will now light the pyrotechnics.
There's some real hobo setup that he's got here. It's obviously not gonna go well.
3, 2, 1.
So signed up for Jackass. Is that completely fake jumping into the wall? Yeah, just remove the padding and then do it again.
Code red! Code red, guys! Guys, we got a code red on our hands.
What?
Oh my gosh, check it out. Now, according to my sources in the field, the waitress is seeing somebody.
Oh shit. I mean, how's Charlie going to handle this, you know? He's been stalking her for so long that I don't know if he can actually be a normal human being about this.
You just said that he was your best friend. How is he your best friend over me?
Well, I mean, you banged the waitress. Do I even have to explain that to you? That kind of rubbed me the wrong way, dude.
Okay, I mean...
Yeah, I mean, you fucked the girlie of his dreams, you know? I mean, to be fair, you think after their musical experiments together... You know, that was some real synergy between them.
Do you think you can find this guy and kick his ass for me?
Absolutely, bro. I will find this guy and I will kick his ass. You know why? Because you and I are best friends.
Yeah, that's what friends do.
He's onto us.
Oh, shit. Mac is banging the waitress. Honestly, I didn't see that coming. I mean, I suppose during the dancing competition in Season 3, Episode 15... They were getting very close to each other, weren't they, in their dance? And it seemed to be, there's some decent chemistry. Or, I mean, I don't know. Maybe she enjoyed that aggression. I don't know.
Hey! Hey! Hey, what's up, buddy?
Hey, man. Where are you going with that?
I was going to throw your sleeping bag in my room because you can stay with me.
Oh, we're going to bunk with him. Yeah, grown men. I don't think you need to. Stay on the couch, maybe.
Okay, well, hey, listen, man. Since you're here and you got all this beer, let's crack a couple of them open. Let's get tipsy.
Yeah, but the beer is for me and Mac.
Oh, shit. You can't say that and then stay at this guy's house. That's a bit rude.
Do something else. Let's do something else. Yeah. Hey, board games, man. Yeah. Let's have a board game night. Chinese checkers. I got,
That's kind of foreign.
I got.
I mean, of course, these guys wouldn't like the Chinese checkers. We know their feeling on the Chinese.
So, you're.
Have you ever spent any. I'm in your way.
I'm
in your way.
Again, you can't say that while you're trying to stay in his house. I mean, I'd kick him out straight then. You're gonna disrespect me like that. I know we just fucked the girl with your dreams, but still.
Just got a couple long range walkie talkies.
Oh, cool. Did you get one for me?
I did not.
Oh, that's all right. I mean, we could probably just.
Yeah, Dennis is incredibly jealous of this situation, and I honestly don't blame him.
All right, whatever. I'll wear the goddamn condom, but I'm not psyched
about it.
This isn't
about condoms, but. Do you really not wear condoms when you have sex with strangers?
What?
I mean, you're not a stranger. I know you don't know her name, but she's not a stranger.
Is it a sex tape?
No. Yes? How do you know that?
Yeah, because he videotapes every chick he bangs. He's got like 1,000 of them. I don't like them, though. It's mostly that horrible angle that you see in porns, you know, where it's all balls and male ass just...
Well, it's just right underneath the legs, yeah. I mean, you don't be watching that for pleasure.
Maybe a little bit later we could do some hand stuff.
Are you in junior high?
Mouth stuff?
Oh my god.
Mouth stuff.
Does she not do that? Sounds boring to me.
Yeah, affirmative. I totally kicked his ass.
Good, man. Hey, what was this jerk's name?
His name,
Don?
Don, like a Italian mobster. I mean, watch him go and find this Don Johnson now, ain't he? Is gonna go kill some random guy.
He forgot to say over and out. I can't believe that.
He's lying.
I mean, why is he holding on like that? This is awkward.
I hate to say this, bro, but I think Mac's banging the waitress.
What are you talking about?
Hey.
No, he wouldn't do that, would he?
Sure.
He's
I don't
a good
have
friend.
Any hard evidence, but that...
Imagine that. All of your friends have slept with the girl of your dreams. I mean, how could you trust any of them, really?
You know where to find me. Over and out.
Over and out. That's what best buddies do. You know, you've got to finish the actual sentence. So now I could do some recon on Mac himself. Does he smell like the cafe girl? Because I'm sure Charlie knows the smell.
If I spend the night on the couch.
Okay. That's cool. Just make sure you go to the bathroom, okay? Before you fall asleep, because I don't want you to piss on the couch again.
Oh, well.
Well, this is a recurring thing for Charlie, yeah? Yeah, yeah.
Seriously, bro, if you piss on the couch again, you're gonna buy some...
I'm not gonna
okay,
piss on the couch,
I just wanna be very clear.
This is actually a tweet that he does. He's known for pissing on couches.
Bye.
All right, good night.
Is that a thing? Sure. Is that a thing people do?
Nice.
And there he is, back in his spider's web, ready to catch his prey.
You wanna come in my room?
I think that sounds just fine.
Come on, Charlie. Come to your real best friend.
I mean, I wouldn't want someone to shrug a Charlie in my room, to be honest. I wouldn't trust. It's going to throw up everywhere, you know. It's not worth it, Dennis. It's not worth it. All to prove a point.
There's a certain situation developing between myself, Charlie, and the waitress that I need to talk to you about.
Proceed.
Oh, you're talking to the wrong person now.
Hey, Dennis, I got you something.
Something. What?
I got your walkie-talkie.
I mean, now these are some real boys. Well, allowing you mate to bang in your own bed. That's a step too far. I don't want anyone touching my bed.
Yeah, bro, but that had to change your mind about who your real best friend is,
I'll
though,
give
huh?
you this much, dude.
And he's still playing it, even
weird,
though he
okay?
knows the truth.
But I need proof. if I'm gonna sell him down the river.
Proof? He told me he was gonna bang her, man.
Maybe the two of you...
Oh, he actually is telling her, yeah. So they're all just trying to fuck each other over. They just don't care about each other, do they?
I'm gonna switch your walkie to that channel, and we're gonna listen to the whole thing. We're gonna catch that son of a bitch red-handed.
Oh my god, that'll work.
Yeah, it's gonna work. And the whole thing's gonna be on tape, too. So you know that video camera I keep in my bedroom?
No.
I got that bad boy running 24-7. It's like a security cam. Except...
Oh, shit. Is she gonna film the sex tape between Mac and the cafe girl? Because that's not very illegal.
Yeah, here we go. W through Z. You should be under W, yeah?
No, my...
Waitress. It's so many waitresses, that's what he goes after.
Star, not good.
Oh, just give that to me.
One star. Is she that bad, really?
No, I'm going to be Charlie. You're going to be Dennis. That's going to be much better for me, trust me. We'll dress you up in his clothes. And then that way we can slip you in and out with ease. Because we got to be very careful. This could be a very, very messy situation. Okay, so I want...
It sounds like they're trying to have sex as the friends. Yeah, that's...
No, you got to be behind me. I got to have you behind me.
What the hell is that all about, man?
I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, how does that even work?
I'm going to refer to you only as Dennis.
When we slip have in, Dennis fuck you.
You're going to start banging me hard.
Okay.
Well, Max gay.
Oh, my God. And Max has no idea what he's doing. What he's just done.
I need you to get Frank and Charlie away from their apartment, okay? I need to get in there without being detected.
Blood Brother 1. Over and out.
He says over and out. I can't believe he just said over and out.
Yeah, he knows the system. Doesn't care about Charlie.
This is sick, but hear me out. I think he wants to be you getting banged by me in your apartment.
Oh, yes.
It's
role
play.
Oh, God, he's got some sick, twisted obsession with us, man.
He's totally obsessed with
that's
us.
That's why he's showing us all those videos and trying to prove to us that he's a badass. He wants to impress us because he's in love with us.
Oh, my God, he's so in love with us.
Yeah, we find out after all this time that those videos are actually his signaling that he's gay. Him coming out the closet.
Look, let's just find a hiding spot, okay?
Okay, good. I'm thinking if I get in the bed and I get real low and flat and maybe you're yes, so they're just on top of me, you know, they won't see us.
Well, how does that work?
Okay, well, see, here's the problem. If I get all balled up and small, I get too high and you'll see that there's someone in the bed.
Then end up accidentally fucking you. I mean, what world does he live in? I mean, he didn't say he snorted glue right now, but I mean, it sounds like he has. Huff glue.
Yeah, I would never say it to his face, but Dennis has great thighs. All right, now let's stop talking and start banging.
He's really... Why are they both under?
Busted.
Oh, we're busted? Because you look pretty busted.
Well, no, this is the best one to hide in my apartment. There's not...
God damn it, Charlie!
why did you agree to it in the first place? Hide behind the curtains. At least that's a tiny bit better.
What are you doing?
Coming in here talking about how in love with my thighs you are.
Yeah, where's in my creamy thighs you're after? I've seen you taking a wearing my...
Oh, she's just going through his clothing. I think he's stolen her knickers or something.
Oh my god. Where's the tape?
What?
The sex tape that Frank made. Where is it?
Frank made a sex tape too?
No, Frank made a sex tape between him.
Oh no, that's gone. Yeah, all right, here's what happened, guys. I thought it was one of Max Project Badass tapes, so I pop in the VCR to watch it. I see what it is. I become violently ill, okay? Then I start smashing. And I smash good.
So that's what you were smashing. Mm. Oh, my God, bro. I thought you were smashing my Project Badass tape because you hated it.
So you did all this just to get back to him about something you didn't actually do?
Yeah, I smashed the crap out of it. Gone.
Great. Good. Thank you, Charlie. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Kind of don't know what else to say.
Say, I will have dinner with you, and thank you for this, and thank you.
That doesn't make any sense.
Just say the words.
No, I will never go out with you. Oh, my God!
I will say them for you. You sh-
You just can't get over it. It's just always going to be obsessed. But hopefully it's the only thing she regrets. I've got a feeling you're not going to regret much.
Because the worst.
Oh, yeah, man, she's terrible. Gross. Yeah. Only got one star from me.
I saw that.
Oh, yeah, you're watching my tapes again?
Yeah.
What'd you think?
You got weird balls.
Mm. You should see Frank's balls.
Well, slumpy.
They're like planets.
Mm.
You know what?
Yeah, two giant knockers, you know, space balls.
Let's put it behind us and let's concentrate on what's really important.
Hello, and welcome to Project Badass Volume 16.
Badass videos, yeah.
Here goes.
I mean, what about the smoke makes it badass?
Two, three, badass.
You're just gonna really miss. Oh no, nice. It's absolutely flattened out. Yeah, it's just trying to peacock. Oh, yeah. The absolute mini explosions. Okay, so this was an episode that definitely could have been solved with just a little bit of communication between the gang. Right? Obviously, we were missing a few of the members. We got the trio. And their battle between best friends. You know, who gets the slots. But yeah, most of it would have been solved. Just, you know, talk to them. If they are your best friend, surely you can just have an adult conversation. You know? Well, I didn't like that you broke my tape. And then Charlie said, I didn't break your tape. There we are. You know? Now, I mean, surely his grievances with the other guys somewhat make sense. You know, Dennis slept with the girl of his dreams, the girl he really likes. But, you know, definitely against bro code. Then again, you know, not Bagsy in a person, are you? So, a person that will never sleep with you has shown no interest in sleeping with you. So, I mean, while you could say perhaps that's a bad friend, so in that situation, they are all in the wrong. But then, you know, yeah, again, you know, I don't blame Charlie for holding a grudge against Dennis. See, I wonder if he's going to hold that grudge against Mac now. Yes, I don't think they actually did bang, but he was actively trying to bang her. And I think that probably counts for something. And the cafe girl needs to stop sleeping with people for revenge, you know? It's obviously not helping her out if she just happened to get into two sex tapes that she didn't want to be in. Like, use your eyes, girl. I mean, well, this is 2000, you know, the gigantic cameras on a tripod. I mean, you're not missing that. You just chose to sleep with a guy in front of the camera that had a red light flashing on it. You're going to have some kind of self-awareness. See, I do wonder if Charlie will ever manage to grate her down enough to actually get in a relationship or a date or sleep with her. See, I'd like to think no, but we know she isn't the smartest person who is obsessed with Dennis. Even after the last time he fucked her over, I'm sure she's gonna come slithering back eventually. After this weird pose or something like that. You know, it is spiderweb. You know? I don't know why he was doing that. It felt like some kind of entrapment. Charlie can't escape. And I'm assuming he thought it made him look a lot more friendly and open. So if you watch the body language gurus, that's probably what they'd say. Well, it was quite funny at the end where, you know, Mac and the cafe girl were planning their escapade and trying to film it. You know, pretending to be Charlie and Dennis. And just the fact that they were listening in at that point, it really did make Mac sound dodgy. So he was unaware of his wording of what he was saying, you know. I mean, it wouldn't surprise me if Mac turned out to be the gay one of the group. Especially in like the later seasons. So I think it probably fit his character. Because yeah, why is he obsessed with making those videos of his? The extreme videos. Alright, where's he sending them to? Like, he was trying to do some stunts for no reason, not showing off to his friends if they're the only people that are going to see it. You know, his leather jacket, his BMX bike, his pyrotechnics, which is just a bit of smoke. But yeah, that was cool. If you like this video, make sure you leave a like, rating, and subscribe so you can see what you're on next. Comment down below what you thought about this episode. And yes, I will see you later.